Hello friends, welcome again at way2testing.com, and my name is Chandan. In this video tutorial, we will discuss about final keyword and finally blog. And first of all, this is my website. You will get all the required study material over here, like different automation, Selenium, Core, Java tutorial, and then manual testing database tutorial. And this is my YouTube channel, software testing tutorial, way2testing, where you will get your required study material in video. So without delay, let's move on the Eclipse and write a code for final. So let me move this one. I will create a new class. Just right click on it. New class. Now give a name to the class. So I will give it name as final and finally. Final and finally. So this is my class name. Now I will create a main method. So I will give it name as public static. So also I will give this webpage description link in my video, and if we'll talk about the final keyword, then it means it is used when where we want the restriction. Suppose that we want to restrict user to for a variable, for a method, or for a class, then we will use the final keyword. So also I have described these all things in my blog, which is way2testing.com. Here you can get a overview of the final keyword. So in Java, where we want the restriction, we use the final keyword. We can use final keyword with the class method and variable. Final class cannot be inherited, final method cannot be overwritten, and final variable cannot be changed. Let's see these all things in the real-time example. So we have created a class. Suppose that I have a variable int x is equal to 0. Now I have, suppose I have another variable, let's make some value int x is equal to 10, and I have second variable. What it will do? It will do x plus 10. Now if I will change the value of y, now as we all know, now the value of x is 20. Let me print this one, this out. My Eclipse is slow because a lot of processor running over there right now. So let me print this one. Your result is, as we all know, now the value of x is 20. Because we have modified this value, means we have done a summation and then we have transferred this y value to the x. Let me run this one. So if we will run this one, we will get the output 20. So what we have done, actually we have changed the value of x, which was initially 10. Now after some operation, we have changed this value from 10 to 20. Now if we want to put a restriction that nobody in the project can be, should be able to change my this value of x, means it should remain constant in the complete cycle of project. So what I will do, I will just put a final keyword. Always remember, final is a keyword and finally is a blog and finalize is a method. So if I will put the final keyword, then nobody will be able to change the value of x. You can see here is an error that it will say remove final modifier of x. So this is the example, as I described in my blog, that final variable cannot be changed. Now second thing, suppose that I have a class like class test1, and it have some method like public void sum. So this have method, and now suppose that I'm just printing something like result. I am inside class test1. And suppose we have another class with the same method name. I have another class with the same method name. If I will create an object of my classes like that, test2 object is equal to new test2. So suppose that we have two classes which have the same method name like sum, and I want to execute my method dot object dot sum. So you can see that the result will be, yeah, I am inside class test2, means we have executed this method, and in the same way we can create the object of class test1, and we can execute this one like with a dot sum. Yeah. Now that one. So suppose that we have two classes, and whenever we want to execute the method of the associated classes, we just need to create the object and we can execute the method. It was the, so you can see that everything is working properly. But suppose this class has extended my first class, which was test1. Now you can see that both have the same method name. This concept called the polymorphism. If you have not seen my polymorphism video, then please have a look. So now if I will run this one, so let's see, you can see that my method will be overridden. So let me run this one. Yes, you can say that my this method has been overridden over here. So suppose that we have used the extend keyword, and we have inherited test1 class over here. So we have this method here. So suppose that we do not have this method. If I will run this one, what will happen? This method will get executed. You can see this one. Yes, this one has been executed. Means what we have done, we have just inherited this class here in test2. But suppose that I want to restrict someone or user so that this method cannot be overridden. So how we can do so? So we can do it by using a final keyword. If I will put this one, you can see that you will get some error that if some method have the final keyword, then this method cannot be overridden. You will get this method. If you want to execute this one, then you have to remove this final keyword. So this is the way to restrict the user to override the method. So we were talking about this one. Now we will talk about the class level. So suppose that, yeah, if I want the user to restrict that no user should be able to inherit my class, so what I need to do, I just write only here final keyword, then you can see the error will appear here. It will say remove final modifier of the test 1. Means in this way we can restrict the user to inherit the class, to override the message, to change the value of the variable. This is the core concept of the final keyword. Now let's discuss about the finally. Finally block. Finally is a block basically. Suppose that we are inside a try and catch a block, and let me take one example. Oh, this is not, this is, yeah. Suppose that we are inside a try and catch a block. Let me remove this one. Suppose that there is a try and catch a block like this. And suppose that there is a equal to 100/0. So we all know that it will throw some exception and it will be captured over here. Let me remove this one. Okay, if I will run this one, you can see that exception will appear and this out. Let me run this one. You can see that the exception will appear by 0. Means we are dividing the value by 0, so we are getting the exception. Suppose that I need some task to perform over here. So hello way to testing. So as we know that if this block have some error or exception, then it will not be executed. This will be executed. This catch a block will be executed. Now, suppose that I want to print this message, hello way to testing. Then, if I will run this one, you can see that it will not get executed because here exception occurs. It will remove all the thing and it will move to here. But I have to print this line. Then what I need to do? The simple way is that I will put it here. Whether exception will occur, then it will print this one. If exception will not occur, then it will print this one. But by this way, we can see that we are making some duplicacy, which is not allowed for a good programmer. So to avoid these all things, we have one solution. It is the finally block. So the code written inside the finally block will be executed whether exception occur or not. So what I will do, I will just copy it and I will push it here and I will remove here. So whether exception will occur or not occur, this finally block will be executed. This is a very simple concept for the finally. You can see that exception has been occurred, but still our code has been executed. So this is all about the final and finally block. So thanks for watching. Have a good day.